And let's do some other stories. And a minority member on Constitutional, Legal and Parliamentary Affairs, Joe Osei Owusu, says the consideration by the police administration to block social media sites on the day of election is unwise and impossible. The Bekwai MP says the ban has no basis in legal, in law, and is illegal. The IGP has said the police administration may consider banning social media sites on the day of election. And I have in the studio DSP Freeman Tete, who is with the police public affairs unit, and also a social media expert, Pop Out Ghana, Maximus Ametoga. Ametogo. Okay, thanks for that. So I have DSP Freeman Tete and also Magnus Ametogo. Thanks, gentlemen, for joining me here in the studio.
Thank you.
Let me start with you, ASP Freeman Tete, because this directive is coming from your end. First of all, I would want to find out if the police is on social media.
Surely we are on social media, Twitter, Facebook, YouTube. So we're very active on the social media.
Well, okay, before we continue with the conversation,
even WhatsApp.
Let's listen to what the IGP said, and then we'll come back to the studio and do the discussions.
The other alternative that is also the police will also be IT compliant by trying to get this our social media to be able to counteract this on time. Mm-hmm. So we are looking at the variables. I can't do the we shall come out with a decision.
Before I come to my guest in the studio, let's hear from the minority spokesperson on Constitutional, Legal and Parliamentary Affairs, Joe Osei Owusu. Hello, good afternoon, sir, and thanks for joining us.
Good afternoon.
Well, you said that there is no basis for consideration by the police administration to ban social media, especially on the election day. Why so?
Yes, I want to find out which law has granted the power to the police to do any such thing. In fact, we must start from the premise that nobody has the power to do anything which the law has not granted him to do. Okay. That is the whole essence of constitutional and legal regimes. I have my freedoms. I'm part of a country. Through election and constitutional process, I've donated or delegated my power to regulate my activity. Now, if there's anything you don't want me to do, you put it in the law. If there's any power you want to exercise, which takes away part of my freedom, you put it in the law, determine who should exercise that power and how it should be exercised. Now, as is the, I'm not aware of any legislation that grants the power to the IGP or the police, for that matter, to interfere with my freedom to interact with my colleagues through any social media. That's why I want to know the basis from which the IGP says to shut down social media.
Well, so let's put the legal issues aside. If the police realizes that such, people posting information on social media during a day like the election day could trigger violence and all that, don't you think they have the right to do what they want to do?
My dear, let's not make that mistake of saying you put legality aside. You should never, ever put legality aside, because that is the basis of all the things we do. That is the basis of the Constitution. Now, if the police find that any activity of anybody contravenes any specific law, he is entitled to use that law to prosecute the person, arrest the person, detain the person. But we should not permit anybody, not the president, not me, an MP, or not you, to say that, in my view, your activity may constitute a crime if that crime is not defined. So there's no room to put outside the law.
Well,
if
so
the police find that there is a growing trend which is dangerous, it is open to them through their minister to propose legislation which passed into law will grant them that authority.
Okay. All right. Thanks so much for throwing light on this particular issue. We are so grateful to you. I have been speaking with a minority spokesperson on Constitutional and Legal and Parliamentary Affairs, Joe Osei Owusu. Thanks for joining us. Let me come back to the studio. And my question was, is the police on social media.
Surely, the police is on social media.
So, is this ban not going to affect the police? Because you also get information, you send out information through social media.
Well, if I say this ban, whatever, the IGP just giving a hint, and then the process is long. The fact that he has said is one of the alternatives, is an option, does not suggest that that is the definite position of the police. The police just don't want to get there. But at the end of the day, we have to ask, it's for the interest of the country. It's just a warning to the public to be responsible on social media. With that, a discussion has been rolled out for all of us to find a way to sanitize social media. So the IGP, in under no circumstances, is suggesting that definitely social media will be blocked. Security implications in some of the utterances being churned out on social media. Some of them are so scary, very dangerous. It is for the collective interest of all of us that the IGP is trying to break a lot of people who are active on social media. Be very responsible, because it can get to a point that process will be initiated if the situation is getting out of hand for all of us.
His message, was he cautioning people, or was...
Well, all of us has expressed that concern. He is the head of the police, and when it comes to election security, the police are the lead agent. So the head of the National Security Task Force is just telling Ghanaians that let's be responsible on social media. Social media has a lot of positives. For example, I cannot live without social media. My whole life will be shut down. I'm very active on social media. My friend here knows very well, because we are friends on social media. Yeah. But when it gets to a point that it will undermine the security of this country, the way forward is to block it. But we don't want to get there. We are cautioning people. There's a way to check. One of the alternatives is just a block on the D-Day. It's just, but the fact that the IGP has said there will be, that consideration is also on the table. And there are other considerations as well. So it is up to us to be responsible in the usage of the social media. The IGP is not saying come on the 2nd, or sorry, on the 7th of November, which is a tentative election day. We are going to block social media. That is not the position of the IGP.
Okay.
That is not the position of the police.
Let me get to the social media expert also and get his thoughts on this particular issue. How realistic, is it realistic, you know, for such a consideration to even come out in the first place?
We were a bit surprised that our father of security even said that it was an alternative. Because for us, we also use social media, and the percentage of even Ghanaians on social media is not even close to 20% of voter population as we have it. So if we have a lot of people, maybe more than 50% on social media platforms, and you think it will be a threat to security on the D-Day, that's why the Honorable was saying there should be a legal backing for that particular action, even if you want to take it. Because I know that in May 2001, the UN Human Rights met, and they came up with some recommendations, even proposing that even internet is a human right because it facilitates people's expressions of views and freedom. They even recommend that in no terms should even member states even block internet access, even in the case of political unrest, because it would be an overkill. How many people even share political content on social media? Very few. So on the D-Day, you want to shut everybody off. And there's no even legal backing for it, because in the Electronic Communications Act, it is the president who have the mandate to even take over telecommunications in the country in times of emergency and war. So the president has to even order even the IGP to take whatever action. But with the UN arrangement, I think Ghana will be discrediting our democratic credentials if we even go into that particular space of even blocking social media. Because in the latest geopool, even digital access in Ghana is the third media that we even consume.
Okay.
So radio comes first before TV, before even digital, and then newspaper. So if you have 300 and something radio stations across the country, why don't you consider banning blocking radio stations so people don't even have access to you because there are only more radio sets than all that. So why are you considering just social media?
How?
And just a minute part of the content they share should even alarm the police to shut down the whole platform. So we don't buy into that idea.
DSP, how easy would it be for the police to do or to embark upon on this particular mission? Let me put it that way.
The police are being pushed to a corner that the police are taking a definite position.
Why would you say the police are being pushed to the corner?
The IGP is only sounding a warning to those who are abusing social media. So all of us has a responsibility to clean the mess, to act responsibly on social media. There are a lot of alternatives. So it's only saying the last alternative is to initiate moves for possible or block of the social media on the day of election. It's actually in response to a question posed to him.
But on the day of elections, you know, people share information a lot.
Surely.
People are not going to receive information on that day.
We will continue to be reviewing the security situation. If it is the language, the attitude on the social media is likely to pose a great danger to this country, the IGP can make a recommendation to those who are responsible. It could be legal for the Attorney General, among others. Those are things that you and I wouldn't be in a position to tell. The IGP is a member of the National Security Council. He can make some of these recommendations. So it's not a unilateral decision that the police will be taking. But being the head of National Security Task Force, he's only telling Ghanaians to be wary of some of the things that are going on in the social media that are likely or are undermining state security. Why can't we all be concerned about state security? Why can't all of us be concerned about the peace and stability of this country rather than taking that issue out of context? We need that peace. We need that stability in this country, even after November 7th. Life must go on. So it's an appeal, beside that utterance being a warning, it's also an appeal to Ghanaians to be responsible on social media. So people must take up that campaign from here. I'm even expecting that Ghanaians should rather be commending the IGP for raising that issue for us to discuss so that we can even form cliques on countering indecency on social media. We can form civil society organizations to counter or to condemn those acts. And we can even go a step ahead by, I understand Facebook, I'm not highly technological savvy. But understand there's a way that you can even report certain conduct, certain write-up, certain attitude on social media to Facebook and you block that person. There are a lot of alternatives. Yeah. So we will not get there, and I don't think we'll get there. So Ghanaians should be rest assured that the IGP is concerned as the head of police and as the head of security task force. So if you are in the position of the IGP, you will definitely come out with that concern. And what do you expect the police to do? To recommend a blocking if the situation is getting out of hand.
You have been monitoring social media for a very long time. That is how come maybe that concern was raised or came about. What, from the time that he made that announcement or that he made that statement, what has been the trend now?
Well, I must be very honest. I had a few engagements outside, so I've not actually been on social media for the past 3 days. So just that I have to. I was in touch with B, so I had information on some of the reactions.
Okay.
And that is why I'm even here, to correct that impression that the police are not taking a definite position to block social media. The police are only concerned, and also advising Ghanaian to be wary and to be responsible on social media. And I know my brother here will lead that campaign so that I will sanitize.
Yeah, so let me get to you. If the police goes ahead or want to, or insists that they would go ahead to do or go ban social media, especially on the day of election, how easy would that be for them to do?
It's not going to be easy. Even from the legal front, it's going to be difficult because people can take you on. Even in Uganda, some of the telecom companies are considering taking the government to court to pay for their profit loss on that day. They banned the social media platforms, okay, because they needed a warrant to take to telecom companies for them to block the internet access to those platforms. And sometimes they have to shut the whole internet in this country. So legally, Ghana, we don't have any legal arrangement to even call for that. Even there are applications that you can use to even bypass that. So even if you block Facebook, Twitter, and whatever, WhatsApp and the rest, you can have that on your phone and you still bypass that particular blocking. You can still do your Facebooking and stuff. And I think this call for the blocking, or even the idea of it, even force people to install those applications on their phone, so that even happens a D-Day, they will be able to do their Facebooking and tweeting and the rest. Now, all these platforms have policies and terms of usage.
Okay.
So we were in this country where even minors' videos were made around, and it was blocked by WhatsApp because they took their documents to WhatsApp and they cross-checked they were minors, and in their policy, they are against promotion of child pornography. So that content was blocked on WhatsApp. On Facebook, there are different levels of control. Okay, you can control the content. So if you see any content that is a harassment or an abuse or defamation of somebody, you can report it immediately to the platform, and they respond immediately by sending you a reply and sending the other person a reply that, hey, either pull this thing down or we block your account. And sometimes they even do an outright block of the account. They can even suspend your account. So I think if we have the police present there, I know my senior brother is on the social media platform, and we should police the platform by having your presence there actively, so that if there's an incident of misinformation or even somebody trying to cause public panic and the rest, you can just tag the police in it, so for them to take action, just like the way now you have the police very visible and present in our society. Yeah, they are not blocking off areas, but they are present there. So people don't do the wrong thing because you know the police is there. Somebody can easily report you, and they can only see you if you do anything wrong. So they should have an online strategy, and some of us are ready to help them for free to be able to sanitize the social media space so that we can upheld that our democratic credentials the world over. Because if you're using Uganda, Bangladesh, Hong Kong, North Korea, and the rest, comparing it to Ghana as the best practice to even come up with that idea, I think it's an overkill. We should not bracket ourselves in the same space as those countries.
In short, it means that banning social media,
they should not
even
ban
for
it.
A day.
Not even in a day, because even it's work. Against the UN recommendations that we have ratified.
All right.
Point of correction, the Inspector General of Police
is
not having those countries in mind. We are dealing with our local situation here.
Freeman,
but you should base your
best practices.
So your country was mentioned under jurisdiction. So it could be Brazil.
He mentioned the countries.
What happened in Brazil during the impeachment, the voting on the impeachment? I've been told that social media was blocked.
It wasn't social media, it was just WhatsApp that was blocked. Okay. So the other social medias were active.
Well,
yes. Okay. The conversation goes on and on and on. And we hope that on that day, we will not block social media because the media especially will need it. Even the police, I think, you need it because people
surely
would want to
it.
Send messages, you know, things happening.
So I'm very
around.
Happy and also glad that my brother has said a lot about what Ghanaians can do to sanitize social media. Yeah. And I believe he's very active on social media.
Exactly.
I didn't know he's the one I'm going to sit here with. He's my friend on social media.
Yeah.
I just want to tax him to lead that crusade. And there are like-minded
people. He's already
people.
Said he'll do something for
there
free,
are like-minded people.
All right, so thanks so much for joining me here in the studio. We are so grateful to you. I